కొలిస్టిటోమా. సో కొలిస్టిటోమా, బిట్స్ ఆన్ కొలిస్టిటోమా, ఐ విల్ టెల్ బ్రీఫింగ్ అబౌట్ దిస్. ఇట్స్ త్రీ డైమెన్షనల్ ఎపిడర్మల్ కనెక్టివ్ టిష్యూ స్ట్రక్చర్. త్రీ డైమెన్షనల్ ఎపిడర్మల్ కనెక్టివ్ టిష్యూ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆల్వేస్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ శాక్. ఓకే, ఆక్యుపైస్ ద స్పేస్ విచ్ ఇస్ అవైలబుల్. ఎరోడ్స్ ద బోన్. ఓకే, టెన్స్ టు రికర్ ఈవెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీట్ రిమూవల్. ఎ త్రీ డైమెన్షనల్ ఎపిడర్మల్ కనెక్టివ్ టిష్యూ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆల్వేస్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ శాక్ ఆక్యుపైస్ ద స్పేసెస్ అవైలబుల్. ఓకే, ఎరోడ్స్ ద బోన్ అండ్ టెన్స్ టు రికర్ ఈవెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీట్ రిమూవల్. దట్ ఈస్ కొలిస్టిటోమా. మిస్నోమర్ ఫర్ కొలెస్ట్రాల్ ఇస్ ప్రెసెంట్, ఇట్ ఇస్ రాంగ్. ఓమా ఈజ్ నాట్ ఎ ట్యూమర్. సో బోత్ ఆర్ రాంగ్ నేమ్స్ ఓన్లీ. ఓకే, నెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కొలెస్ట్రాల్ నాట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓమా ట్యూమర్. సో ఎపిడర్మల్ కనెక్టివ్ టిష్యూ స్ట్రక్చర్. ఎపిడర్మల్ మీన్స్ స్టాటిఫైడ్ స్క్వామస్ ఎపిథీలియం. ఓకే, ప్రైమరీ కొలిస్టిటోమా, సెకండరీ కొలిస్టిటోమా. ఓకే, కంజెనిటల్ కొలిస్టిటోమా. కంజెనిటల్ కొలిస్టిటోమా జస్ట్ బిఫోర్ ద బర్త్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ దే ఆర్ ఫార్మ్. ఓకే, సో మిడిల్ ఇయర్ పెట్రస్ ఎపెక్స్ అండ్ సెరిబెల్లో పాంటైన్ యాంగిల్, దీస్ ఆర్ ద త్రీ కామన్ ప్లేసెస్ ఫర్ కంజెనిటల్ కొలిస్టిటోమా. మిడిల్ ఇయర్ పెట్రస్ ఎపెక్స్ అండ్ సెరిబెల్లో పాంటైన్ యాంగిల్. మిడిల్ ఇయర్ దట్ ఈస్ మిడిల్ ఇయర్ పెట్రస్ ఎపెక్స్, ఎపెక్స్ ఆఫ్ ద పెట్రస్ టెంపోరల్ బోన్. దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఎపెక్స్ ఆఫ్ ద పెట్రస్ టెంపోరల్ బోన్, ఆర్ లెఫ్ట్ టెంపోరల్ బోన్. అండ్ దెన్ సెరిబెల్లో పాంటైన్ యాంగిల్ విద్ ఇన్ ద బ్రెయిన్ వేర్ ఇన్ యూ హ్యావ్ గాట్ ఎకోస్టిక్ న్యూరోమా. సెరిబెల్లో పాంటైన్ యాంగిల్, దీస్ ఆర్ త్రీ కామన్ సైడ్స్. దట్ ఈస్ కంజెనిటల్ కొలిస్టిటోమా. ఓకే, ప్రైమరీ కొలిస్టిటోమా వితౌట్ ఎనీ డిసీజ్ దట్ ఈస్ అకరింగ్. ఓకే, వితౌట్ ఎనీ డిసీజ్ ఇన్ ద ఇయర్ దట్ ఈస్ అకరింగ్ ప్రైమరీ కొలిస్టిటోమా. ప్రైమరీ అక్వైర్డ్, సెకండరీ అక్వైర్డ్. సో కంజెనిటల్ ఆర్ అక్వైర్డ్. సో అక్వైర్డ్ రిలేటెడ్ టు ప్రైమరీ ఆర్ సెకండరీ. సెకండరీ మీన్స్ ఆల్రెడీ డిసీజ్డ్ ఇయర్. ద ఇయర్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ డిసీజ్. ఐఎమ్ ఆల్రెడీ హ్యావింగ్ ఎ సేఫ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ సిఎస్ఓఎం, ఐఎమ్ గెటింగ్ కొలిస్టిటోమా. దట్ ఈస్ సెకండరీ అక్వైర్డ్. ప్రైమరీ మీన్స్ ద ఇయర్ సీమ్స్ టు బి నార్మల్ బట్ దెర్ ఈస్ సమ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ కొలిస్టిటోమా. లైక్ ఎనీ రిట్రాక్షన్ పాకెట్, ద ఇయర్ ఈస్ ద టింపానిక్ మెంబ్రేన్ ఇస్ సక్డ్ ఇన్సైడ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ నెగిటివ్ ప్రెషర్. సో వేర్ ఇన్ యూ హ్యావ్ గాట్ ఆల్ థియరీస్. ఓకే, సో ప్రైమరీ కొలిస్టిటోమా ఈజ్ బై మీన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇంప్లాంటేషన్ థియరీ, బేసల్ సెల్ హైపర్ప్లేసియా. ఓకే, అండ్ స్క్వామస్ మెటాప్లేసియా. ఓకే, స్క్వామస్ మెటాప్లేసియా. అండ్ సెకండరీ కొలిస్టిటోమా ఇస్ బై మైగ్రేషన్ అండ్ మెటాప్లేసియా. సో కొలిస్టిటోమా బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దట్ ప్రైమరీ ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ మిడిల్ ఇయర్ కొలిస్టిటోమా. సో కొలిస్టిటోమా ఈజ్ ఎ త్రీ సేమ్ థింగ్, త్రీ డైమెన్షనల్ ఎపిడర్మల్ కనెక్టివ్ టిష్యూ స్ట్రక్చర్, టెన్స్ టు రికవర్ ఈవెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీట్ రిమూవల్. ఈవెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీట్ రిమూవల్ మీన్స్ ద ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఈస్ సర్జరీ ఓన్లీ. సో వెన్ యూ ఫైండ్ కొలిస్టిటోమా దెర్ ఇస్ నో ఛాన్స్ ఫర్ ఎనీ అదర్ ఆప్షన్, సర్జరీ ఓన్లీ. మెడికల్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ మేనేజింగ్ ద డిసీజ్ ఫర్ సమ్ ఎక్స్టెంట్. ఫర్ కొలిస్టిటోమా సర్జరీ ఈజ్ ద ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ చాయిస్. వాట్ ఇస్ ద ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ చాయిస్? ఎంఆర్ఎం. సో బ్లైండ్లీ రిమెంబర్, కొలిస్టిటోమా సర్జరీ ఎంఆర్ఎం. సో మాడిఫైడ్ రాడికల్ మాస్టాడెక్టమీ, సో మెడికల్ అండ్ సర్జికల్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ బట్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ చాయిస్ మీన్స్ ఓకే యూ వాంట్ టు గెట్ ఎ డాగ్ ఆర్ ఎ ఫాక్స్ మీన్స్ ఐ సే ఐ వాంట్ ఎ ఫాక్స్. సో యూ కెనాట్ గెట్ ఎ డాగ్ అండ్ షో దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ లుకింగ్ లైక్ ఎ ఫాక్స్ అండ్ యూ కెన్ యూ మేనేజ్ విత్ ద ఫాక్స్. దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ద ఇష్యూ. ఐ వాంట్ ఫాక్స్ ఓన్లీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ స్పెసిఫికలీ ఇఫ్ దే ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ మిడిల్ ఇయర్ ప్రైమరీ ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ కొలిస్టిటోమా ఇస్ సర్జరీ ఓన్లీ. యూ వాంట్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ యువర్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ఎబిలిటీ. ఓకే, సో మెనీ క్వశ్చన్స్ యూ కెన్ ఆన్సర్ లైక్ దిస్. 5 year boy diagnosed to have posterior superior retraction pocket. Posterior superior retraction pocket, cholesteatoma. All would constitute a part of management except posterior superior retraction pocket. Okay. So audiometry, mastoid exploration, tympanoplasty and myringoplasty. So what could be the probable answer over here? Here they want you to understand about the difference between audiometry has to be done definitely. How much loss? Okay. So I lost the ear sensation, hearing sensation. How much loss you will be asking? I will go for audiometry. As I already told you, modified radical mastoidectomy is the treatment of choice. TOC, treatment of choice is MRM. Okay, tympanoplasty and myringoplasty. So when I am going into the ossicle status, it is called as tympanoplasty. When I am not going into the ossicular status, it is myringoplasty. So that is the difference. So just going to the ear, middle ear, I am just changing the tympanic membrane and coming back. Okay, I'm just changing the tympanic membrane and coming back. But I am changing the tympanic membrane and also repairing the ossicular damage caused by the cholesteatoma, it is tympanoplasty. Just putting a graft is myringoplasty. Without looking anything, blindly putting a graft is myringoplasty. For example, fat myringoplasty. I find a hole in the tympanic membrane. I take some fat from the lobule. I put it there. That is fat myringoplasty. That's it. Okay. But tympanoplasty includes eradication of the disease, reconstruction of the hearing mechanism, plus or minus graft. So answer would be meningoplasty. So based on this explanation, so except means you have to be exceptionally perfect in that particular answer. Yeah, they did not give that. Okay, so they did not ask that. So most of the times diagnosed posterior superior retraction pocket. Okay, you need not understand about that. So posterior superior retraction pocket leading to primary disease only. Okay, retraction pocket is not known why it is occurring. Okay, until then the disease here was supposingly normal. Okay, it is not congenital cholesteatoma. It is primary. As far as you are asking, it should be primary only. The further questions we will be seeing that. Okay, you will get explanation for everything, but in a zigzag manner, because we are not going as a class, we are going as a MCQs. Okay, I'll try to explain you there when I get it. The posterior superior retraction pocket, if allowed to progress, it will lead to sensory neural hearing loss, primary cholesteatoma, tympanosclerosis, tertiary cholesteatoma. There is nothing like tertiary cholesteatoma till now, as far as I don't know, but maybe it is there in some other books. Okay, tertiary cholesteatoma is not used, so keep it aside. Tympanosclerosis. Tympanosclerosis is nothing but a chalky white precipitate occurring inside the temporal bone. So whatever the pathology occurring in the ear is not a ear pathology, it is a pathology of the temporal bone, and it is a representative of temporal lobe of the brain. Temporal bone is a representative of temporal lobe of the brain because there is auditory hearing center, area number 41, Brodmann's area. So always remember the tympanosclerosis. Tympano means something related to media, sclerosis means heart. Sclerosing mucositis and osteoclastic periostitis, these are the two pathologies. Sclerosing mucositis, mucosa gets sclerosed, osteoclastic periostitis. So these are the two pathologies leading to tympanosclerosis. So, but that is not related to posterior superior retraction pocket. If there is any problem in the middle ear or in the problem in the tympanic membrane, it leads to this pathology. Sensory neural hearing loss is not directly related to retraction pocket. Retraction pocket is a pathology in the tympanic membrane. Okay, when there is pathology in the tympanic membrane, it leads to conductive deafness. It's not sensory neural hearing loss. Okay, the answer here would be primary cholesteatoma. As this particular thing says you, this particular thing, the eustachian tube dysfunction, which is leading to pulling of negative pressure, attic retraction pocket. Okay, pars posterior superior retraction pocket. What is posterior superior region called? Pars placida. Okay, attic region, pars placida. It is leading to something called as cholesteatoma, primary acquired cholesteatoma. So acquired cholesteatoma is primary and secondary. Secondary is, if you are already having a disease called as CSOM and it is going to give some cholesteatoma, it is secondary acquired. So secondary acquired, the pathology is being explained by this. So all these pictures I am taking the courtesy of Dhingra textbook or the standard textbook. Once you see in the textbook, you will understand it very easily. Okay, it is clearly given, like because of this particular thing, it will be primary cholesteatoma. There might be some, I corrected this something, maybe some mistake in that also, we try to correct this. Okay, because in one thing it is given as primary and one thing it is given as secondary. Once again, 30-year-old male having attic cholesteatoma, attic disease, dangerous disease always, okay. Cholesteatoma of the left ear with lateral sinus thrombophlebitis. Lateral sinus thrombophlebitis. Which of the following is the operation of choice? Lateral sinus thrombophlebitis. It is an intracranial complication of the cholesteatoma. Left ear cholesteatoma. Cholesteatoma, you thought means always you go for modified radical mastoidectomy. Modified radical mastoidectomy is the answer actually. So as far as the options are concerned, intact canal wall mastoidectomy, simple mastoidectomy with tympanoplasty, canal wall down mastoidectomy, mastoidectomy with cavity obliteration. So answer here will be canal wall down mastoidectomy. Canal wall down, the other name for modified radical mastoidectomy. Okay, modified radical mastoidectomy. I want to give a small explanation regarding this one. So for example, this is the tympanic membrane, and this is the mastoid cavity that you are having. Okay, so the canal wall down and canal wall up procedures, you want to know the difference. Canal wall up procedures. Okay, so once you lose the game, they say you are down. This I am trying to explain the basic. You are down, that means you are not down. You are down means you are perished. Okay, there is something called as posterior meatal and lateral attic wall, PM and LA. I am trying to explain you as simple as that. Okay, this is the tympanic membrane, this is the mastoid cavity. So if you see the tympanic membrane, there will be meatal wall, is it or not? This is the external artery meatus, posterior meatus, which is a bony wall, posterior meatal and lateral attic wall. So here will be your pars placida. So what is canal wall down procedure means, middle ear, attic and mastoid cavity are made into a single cavity by removing the posterior meatal and lateral attic wall. Okay, posterior meatal and lateral attic wall, converting the three spaces into a single space. Posterior meatal and lateral attic wall are removed in toto, are removed, and then you are making middle ear, attic and mastoid cavity, ma'am, middle ear, attic and mastoid cavity into a single cavity which is kidney or C-shaped, and putting the graft completely. You are putting the graft completely and doing something called as canalplasty. Middle ear, attic and mastoid cavity are made into a single cavity and canalplasty. You are cutting the canal and opening. You can just see the canal as big as possible. All these are exteriorized. The problem for cholecystoma most commonly is because of lack of ventilation. You are providing some ventilation. So removing all the disease and providing some ventilation, putting a graft. So middle ear and mastoid cavity. Why you should you call this modified radical mastoidectomy as canal wall down? What are the canal wall down procedures? Aticotomy, modified radical mastoidectomy and radical mastoidectomy, AMR. Aticotomy, you are removing the attic, aticotomy, modified radical mastoidectomy and radical mastoidectomy. Okay. So this posterior meatal and lateral attic wall are removed, and then you are communicating all the spaces in a single space so that there is ventilation maintained, all the disease is maintained. Once you are removing, the wall is down. So this is so confusing terminology that you won't understand. Canal wall down, you are removing wall, removing the wall. Canal wall up, okay. He is up in the competition, he won the competition. They say like that. The wording is so confusing. Canal wall up means this particular middle ear and attic, this middle ear and this particular mastoid cavity, the middle wall that is there, that is posterior meatal wall, is up, it is there. It is not removed. Canal wall up procedure. This is canal wall up procedure and this is canal wall down procedure. This is canal wall down and this is canal wall up. So canal wall up procedures are not done for this cholecystoma. But they can be done. In a technical aspect, they can be done once the patient is ready for regular follow-up. Okay. For regular follow-up, and patient should be a highly educated person. If they are not educated person, I don't know, some remote village, the patient is coming to me, I am doing the surgery, I ask him to come after 1 month. No, I am busy with the agriculture, he will be saying. So by the way, if he is not coming regularly, I cannot do this canal wall up procedure. If he is coming regularly, I can do this canal wall up procedure. Like a educated man, whenever he comes to me, I want to clean the whatever debris collected, I will do this one. Canal wall down. So I will do this only for person who are not ready for the follow-up. Okay, canal wall down procedure. That is the difference between these two things. Canal wall up and canal wall down. So as you can see right now, modified radical mastoidectomy is a part of a procedure called as canal wall. As a whole, the procedure is called as canal wall down procedure. Answer is C. So aticotomy, modified radical mastoidectomy and radical mastoidectomy. Okay, it is nothing but. Canal wall up means you are retaining the canal wall. So you should have mastoidectomy with cavity obliteration. What is this cavity obliteration? You are putting some cartilage or some pieces over there to obliterate, some muscle piece, or, you know, to obliterate the cavity. Simple mastoidectomy with tympanoplasty. This canal wall up can be called as simple mastoidectomy with intact canal wall. Okay, canal wall is intact. Intact canal wall mastoidectomy. So this should be understood. Whenever you are calling canal wall down, it includes aticotomy, modified radical mastoidectomy, and radical mastoidectomy. Posterior superior retraction pocket allowed to progress, it will lead to primary cholecystoma, as you have known. So posterior superior quadrant is most dangerous. Why? Because it is related to attic. If this is the right ear, so this is the posterior superior quadrant, it is related to attic and related to mastoid disease. So why it should be so dangerous means it is directly related to tegment tympani erosion leads to middle ear, middle cranial fossa, this erosion. Okay. Which of the following is included in the Levinson criteria for congenital cholecystoma? So for congenital cholecystoma, what are the criteria? They will be asking. Okay, Ferguson criteria, Levinson criteria, Anderson criteria, they can give you a question. So Levinson criteria is for congenital cholecystoma. White mass medial to normal tympanic membrane, and definite history of otoria, history of prior otological procedures, edicoantral perforation of the tympanic membrane. congenital cholecystoma, I told you it is in the middle ear, petrous apex, which are there inside only, we don't know that. What happens is, once we are doing some surgery, sometimes we accidentally find cholecystoma. If you are not going for a CT scan, HRCT temporal bone, we accidentally find a cholecystoma. That particular cholecystoma can be called as congenital cholecystoma. It is slowly developing. Okay, sometimes it erodes the bone because of collagenases and osteases or proteases enzymes that are present. It is damaging the bone also. So that is, answer will be white mass medial to the normal tympanic membrane. So you imagine a pearl that is present medial to the tympanic membrane. Tympanic membrane is normal. It is accidentally discovered. That is Levinson's criteria. And these are all opposite given. There is no perforation as such. There is no history of otolithia. So he has just modified the Levinson criteria and given as a question. So history of prior otological procedures not there. Definitive history of otoria not there. Eticoventral perforation of tympanic membrane is not included. These are all given opposite. Central part of the cholecystoma contains. Answer is keratin debris. So you should know this is given based on this particular one. This is a bone, fibrous stroma, matrix, and keratin. Okay. So how would you remember this? Bollywood film dekhe maza karo. Okay. Bollywood film. By outer what is a bone? F is a fibrous matrix. M is a matrix. And then K is a keratin mass. The end intention of this particular cholecystoma is to collect the keratin. Keratin means something related to hair protein, something like that. This is stratified squamous epithelium. I told you it is the epidermal connective tissue structure. Epidermis means keratin, all rough keratin. This keratin mass is being produced. So bone, fibrous stroma, matrix, and keratin mass. So this is a question that is given based on this particular picture. Foul smelling ear discharge with presence of pale granulation in ear is an adolescent boy suggests to walk. Cholecystoma, exostosis, otomycosis, and malignant otitis externa. Foul smelling ear discharge. So foul smelling scanty, profuse is in safe type of CSPM. Foul smelling scanty is in the case of this aticoenteral disease, which is related to pale granulation tissue in adults and boys suggests to walk. Cholecystoma. Okay, foul smelling. Fishy smell is because of this collagenases and proteases. The collagenases and proteases, they damage the bone. So whenever there is bone damage, like your osteomyelitis patient, you might have seen in the ward of the orthopedics, there will be foul smelling because of this particular cholecystoma. Which of the following structures is not at immediate risk of erosion by cholecystoma? Not at immediate risk. Okay. So there is a not, KNOT not put here by putting a word called as not, NOT not. So it is an opposite, negative question. Okay. Long process of the incus. Is it eroded? Fallopian canal containing facial nerve, is it eroded? So horizontal lateral sensorial canal, is it eroded? Base plate of stapes. So answer here will be D. D will be the answer. Why? Because I'll tell you. So long incudal process, I call it as lip, LIP. Lip is the most commonly involved structure that is in the cholecystoma. So cholecystoma damages the bones. Okay, ossicles are also bones, as I told you, synovial joint in the first question. So long process of the incus is the most commonly damaged bone by means of cholecystoma. Fallopian canal. The canal for the facial nerve is called as Gabriel Fallopius. He is a scientist who gave this canal for facial nerve. This facial nerve, horizontal segment of the facial nerve is being dehiscent and also vertical segment. So horizontal segment is called showing congenital dehiscences. So facial nerve has got horizontal part and then vertical part. So this horizontal part of the fallopian canal is more commonly dehiscent. Next, horizontal or lateral semicircular canal. Lateral semicircular canal is also more commonly dehiscent. And base plate of stapes is least commonly dehiscent. Okay.